anytime you want. You can go to your house 1 o'clock in the midnight, 2 o'clock in the midnight. You that is selling 600 CDs will stay for complete 1 week or 2 weeks. You have not even sold even one. Once see Nigeria as, like, I don't know if they see Nigeria as the mumu people or they see Nigeria as people who doesn't have sense.
Okay, hello, welcome to my channel once again. I have a Nigerian brother here whom I met and he showed me around in Koko, and right now I want him to share with me or with us his experience living in Ghana. So if you haven't subscribed to the channel, please subscribe to the channel, like the video and do what? Share. Thank you. So let's move on to the interview. Yes. Please, your name.
My name is Victor.
Victor.
Yes.
And you are from?
I'm from Nigeria.
Which part of Nigeria?
Igbo.
The Igbo side.
Yes.
So the Igbo side, which part exactly?
I'm from Ebonyi State. Ebonyi State.
Ah, okay, yes. Okay. And for me, I met you in Ghana. What actually brought you here?
Normally, I came here for business purposes. But based on the nature of things, I couldn't be able to achieve the business I came here to do. So, which led me to hustle as a man.
Yeah, definitely. As a man, you need to survive anywhere. Cause...
But the experience I had here in Ghana is really okay.
It's really okay?
Yes.
Okay.
Because number one, if you talk about a peaceful country in Africa, you can count Ghana as one. Ghana is among the most peaceful country.
Okay, actually, I think that 2022, Ghana was rated the second most peaceful country after Mauritius.
Yeah, okay.
Yeah, the second most peaceful country in Africa.
And secondly, if you talk about light, yes, I can count Ghana as number two or number three among the other countries who have steady light. Like, since I came to Ghana here, like, I've not had much experience of NEPA taking light, doing this.
Like, we in Ghana, we call it Dumso.
Okay. So, I've not had that much experience.
Okay.
So, and secondly, people here in Ghana, they are friendly to everybody.
Okay.
If you're a stranger and you come to Ghana to seek for help, you can get it easily. They don't behave, they don't do as if here, this one is from here. They take all the Africans as brother, as one.
Okay.
So the experience I've had here, they have a good water, they have a good road. They have many, their government is very okay. They treat everybody equal.
Okay.
Everybody is equal.
Okay.
They treat everybody as human being.
Okay.
So here in Ghana is a place where you can come and you have rest of mind. Everywhere, like some other countries, there are some places you will go, you'll be having experience of stealing, doing this, doing that. But here, I've not had that kind of experience. You can go anytime you want. You can go to your house 1 o'clock in the midnight, 2 o'clock in the midnight. Nobody will stop you. Nobody will ask where are you going till you get to your house. So the experience I had here in Ghana is something that, yes, I would like to share because it's a very good thing to me. So for some of my brothers, some of other people that would like to come to Ghana, my advice to them is Ghana is very okay, and they are friendly to every person. As long as you are here for a purpose. To my brothers out there, the ones that are planning to come to Ghana here to us, yeah, Ghana is a place where you will come and you will make, as long as you know what brought you here in Ghana,
yeah,
it's very easy for you to achieve what you want.
But you know, sometimes we have some Nigerians that also complain about the treatment that they get from Ghanaians. And what do you have to say about those things? Because especially some people say when they are going to rent, especially,
okay,
it's one problem that they face a lot. Because the moment they get there, and they say they are Nigerians, the landlords don't give them the like the rooms.
Okay, based on that one, like me, the time I came here, though I came to meet someone.
Okay.
So, but as a man, I have to go on my own.
Okay.
So, which the time I wanted to rent a house, also I had the challenges.
Okay.
of landlords saying you are in Nigeria, you are this, you are that. Yeah, but
have you understood the reason why, or did you ask them the reason why they do that?
Yes, I asked one of the landlords because I went to three houses to look for accommodation.
Okay.
So the third one told me that I'm in Nigeria, that I can commit and go back to my country. Then I told the landlord no. That commitment, there's everywhere, like every country have good side and they have bad side of the country. So if you are talking about the bad side of the Nigeria person cannot come here and commit a crime, or unless the people in the country
help them. That's a very good point. Honestly,
you cannot, a Nigerian person don't know much thing about Ghana here.
Exactly,
he doesn't know
true.
The constitution, he doesn't know the law that guide Ghana here. He can't come from Nigeria and commit a crime unless an indigenous of Ghana lead him to that,
crime.
So I told the landlord that you saying that Nigeria are bad people, no. True, we have bad people and we have good people. Also here in Ghana, you have bad people in Ghana, you still have good people in Ghana. So, but you cannot use because of the bad ones and say, oh, everybody. If you want to mention bad person, like if I do you wrong, then say there's one particular person, is a Nigerian guy that did something wrong to me.
Yeah.
Like, he did it in the past.
Okay.
But you can't say that everybody in Nigeria, you can't use because of me personally as yes, everybody in Nigeria is a bad person.
That's very true. It's something I've actually been saying on my channel a lot of time. And I think a couple of videos on there that I say it is not every Nigerian who is bad.
Yes, that is true.
It's not every Nigerian.
And moreover,
not every Ghanaian who is good.
Good. It's not every Ghanaian that are bad.
You know, usually they will say Ghanaians are cool, but it's not every Ghanaian.
It's not every Ghanaian.
That is the thing.
It's not every Ghanaian.
Like, we should just understand.
And mostly, the problem I can tell people that we are facing much here, sometimes is the indigenous of the country. Those who have not traveled to some other countries.
They don't, you know.
Like,
that's very true. If you don't have experience of traveling,
like
you will not understand someone if the person travels into your country, and like you wouldn't understand how to treat these people.
The people. Because some of the youth here,
yeah.
If you argue something with them,
yeah,
they will say, "Omo Naija." Omo Naija, Omo Naija. Like those kind.
What's
of
the meaning of that Omo Naija?
The Omo Naija, like that Omo Naija, is just where Omo is. A boy.
Okay.
He's a boy too, because it's a Yoruba language.
So Naija boy.
Yes, Naija boy is
okay,
the boy.
Okay.
So they will just say Omo Naija, yeah, bad papa. Not like all the
like we are bad.
You are bad. So like sometimes I do ask them, what is the bad side of the Nigeria? You can't just come out and say that Nigerian people are bad, because
true,
you have not gone
true.
To Nigeria. Travel and go to Nigeria, then if you have the experience of the bad side of Nigeria, then you come back and say the Nigerian people are bad. You can't, you are here in Ghana, you are here in Koko, you have not traveled to Kumasi, you have not traveled to Accra, and you will come and say the Nigerian people who travel cross how many countries to come here in Ghana to hustle. And one thing I can tell people is, if you are talking about, sometimes they do say that Nigerian people kill, that is why they don't give Nigerian people house. And they do say Nigerian people spend fake money. I can say it's a lie.
Okay.
And somehow this is truth.
Okay.
With the reasons. One, Nigerian people, there is no any country that doesn't have fake currency.
No, definitely.
Ghana people, they have fake currency. And Nigerian people, they have fake currency. And both euro, dollar, they have fake currency.
Yeah.
Both SFR, they have fake currency. So it's not only Nigeria that has spent fake currency.
Yeah.
But Nigeria, if police people catch you with fake currency, you are going to face the law. So also the same thing to other country.
Yeah.
They cannot, and sometimes the way the Ghanaian people do, when they watch movie, they will say, they will, if they watch Nigerian movie finish, that they will say that, yeah, what they see or what they saw in that movie is what Nigerian people are practicing. Which I do tell them that. Well, what? Yes, they say all Nigerian people are rituals, this, this, and that. Yeah, yeah, ritual. There's, even to do the ritual is not even easy. It's not even easy to do the ritual.
But even Ghanaians do.
And Ghanaians do. Nigerians do. So you can't say that this one is a ritual. This one is a ritual. Nobody knows. They can't write. They don't write it on on forehead. They don't write it on face. That exactly, this person is a ritual. This person is not a ritual. So every person that make, for Ghanaian people, every person that make money in Nigeria is a ritualist. But we don't take it like that. And the one experience I have with Nigerian people, and I really know mostly the Igbo people, is they have experience of business.
No, that one, even Ghanaians, we know that
they have experience of business. A Nigerian person can come to Ghana, can come to Nkoko here, or a Nigerian person can be selling a phone, and a Ghana person will also be selling phone.
Yeah.
Then, Nigerian person will be selling his phone. Is it at 500 CDs?
Yeah.
He will be using 5 CDs as his, he will be making profit on 5 CDs.
Interesting.
Why the Ghanaian person is, you will price the phone 500 CDs. He will say he want to sell it 600 CDs.
That's very true.
Because all his hope are in the phone.
That's very true.
So, but an Igbo man,
and I know.
An Igbo man will say, yeah, let me sell this phone 500 CDs and you will make a profit of 5 CDs. And you that is selling 600 CDs will stay for complete 1 week or 2 weeks. You have not even sold even one. Why the person that is selling 500 CDs will sell and make profit of 500 CDs times, let me say times even 10 or 20 or even 50.
That's very true.
Before you sell one, that person have made the profit of more than what you that sold a 60 CD will make. That is Igbo's life for you. And they believe in their hustling. They believe that if I do this, it will favor me.
No, and they make money.
And we make like
who doesn't
people,
who doesn't want
money.
Cheap stuffs like that are a bit cheaper.
Yeah.
Everybody likes that.
That's true. And secondly, let me say I want to complain for one problem that we the Nigerians are facing here.
Yeah.
Number one is intimidation.
Okay.
Normally, it's not everybody that do the intimidation.
Yeah,
there are mostly, I can see mostly the Nkoko people, somehow. Mm. Some of them, not all.
Oh.
Some of them, those illiterate ones,
they
intimidate Nigerians too much.
Okay.
Like, the illiterate ones see Nigeria as, like, I don't know if they see Nigeria as the Mumu people, or they see Nigeria as people who doesn't have sense, or they see Nigeria as people who, like sometimes they will say, you're from Nigeria to come and pack our money to go to your country.
But
they
are,
do say it.
You know, there are Ghanaians too who are outside.
And there are Ghanaians, I do tell you, there are many Ghanaians who are in Nigeria. If you come to our industry, if you come to the Nollywood industry, you will see many of the Ghanaians Nigeria lived. Even some of them that doesn't even hope that they will, but because of the help of the Nigerians, they are like today, they are happy. There are many of them that if you tell them to come back to Ghana, they will say no. Because their life they are living in Nigeria is really okay for them.
I will advise every Nigerian in Ghana is that, living in Ghana is that, try to ignore these people, honestly.
Yeah, that is the main thing.
Just try and ignore them.
Because
they don't know what
we
don't. Why? Try and ignore them, honestly.
Yeah, because we know, me personally, I know how I ignore them. Sometimes they will say, they will just tell you, Kwasia, oh, mommy, why, all this, this, and all those kinds.
Just ignore.
You will just look at the person and say, okay, like me, sometimes I will tell them, you are telling me I came to your country to pack your mother and go. How many of the Ghanaians that are in Nigeria? Can you count them? You can't count them. If you start treating the Nigerians that way, that means you are bringing a
disagreement of a conflict between
which is no good
countries, yeah.
Because if you start treating the Nigerians that way, the Nigerians over there will start treating your own people that is when
way,
the problem
exactly.
will occur
exactly, yeah.
So which we are the same, we all are the same Africans.
For me,
we are the same,
we are Africans. We should just
it's just only the white people that came and put confusion in us. They will say this one is a Ghanaian, this one is a Nigeria, this one is a Benin, this one is a Togoli, this one is a no. We all are the same Africans.
Yeah.
We have the same black skin.
Black skin,
it's only the language that differentiates us and the tradition. Sometimes I do say like sometimes there are so many traditions that Nigeria that Ghanaian people do, like it will just look to some traditions in Nigeria. So which means sometimes I do appreciate it because every country have their own culture. So and if you check very well, you will know that there are many Nigerians that married Ghanaian. Yeah, there are many Ghanaians that married Nigeria. Like I have so many of them.
So
one thing I can tell some people is they should stop intimidating Nigerians. We are all the same Africans. Even if we came here to pack the money, to pack Ghana money the way they do say, there is no way that we can pack all the money that Ghana people have and go to Nigeria. We will still remain the one that is even more bigger than the one we'll pack. So which money is not something that like a lot of people are not here because of they want to pack money. A lot of people are here because they want to experience
the country.
So a lot of people came here
to do business.
So you can't say that people were the ones who came here to hustle are the ones who came to pack
the money.
No. We don't say.
So say in Ghana, apart from Nkoko, where have you also been to?
Like I've gone to Kumasi once.
Kumasi once, okay.
Yes. I've gone to Kasua.
Kasua, okay.
Accra, like.
Okay.
I've gone to Accra.
Okay.
So,
and if I may ask, when we talk about our food, which one have you tasted before?
Like I've tasted the banku.
Banku.
Yes.
And what again?
And wachi.
And wachi.
Yes.
Is that all?
I've tasted the koko.
Koko. Okay.
Yeah, which Nigeria we call it akam pap.
Akam. Yeah. Pap.
That's
pap. I've seen that.
Then the banku here is very nice. Just that.
Our banku is similar to.
To semovita. It's just similar to semovita or
this thing.
Fufu. Sala is a soup.
I'm talking about wheat.
Wheat, yeah. Yeah, it's similar to wheat.
But
and also
color,
similar to
it's
to
just a color
semo.
That is different.
Yeah. Just the color that is different.
It's different, yeah.
So the food is very nice.
Yeah.
And most the problem some people here have is they don't eat vegetables because the reason why sometimes
I don't eat vegetables, but you know that only you know like mostly the leaves that we have, we mostly use it to prepare medicine. We drink it raw like that.
But
for you guys, I know something like bitter leaf, for
bitter
instance,
leaf soup. We
you
use
it to cook. But for us, if a Ghanaian wants a bitter leaf soup, like a bitter leaf right now, they would rather cook it and drink it separately. That's how like we do it here.
And we have many vegetable, green leaf, like we have many vegetables.
For us in Ghana, I think kontumre, that's the leaves of cocoyam.
Cocoyam
leaves. That's I think the only major thing that we use to prepare food.
But sometimes they do say that this cabbage.
Yeah, we have cabbage, we have carrots and all that, like
carrot,
those ones.
But they those do ones, join it together it's, say it's a carrot.
We do vegetable stew and we use carrots, cabbage, cucumber.
Yes, also
and
the same thing to Nigerian people.
Yeah.
They do use cabbage, carrot and some other food to prepare it, which is very nice.
Okay, so I want to give you a last minute to finalize what everything that you said. Your stay in Ghana, how much are you going to rate it from 1 to 10?
Like my stay in Ghana, apart from the intimidation and the there's not much thing apart from the intimidation and sometimes the police intimidation.
Are police people to intimidate you?
Because they will say you don't have residence permit, and if you are driving a motor, you are driving a car, you are driving Okada, they will, if you go to do driving license, they will say you are not a Nigerian. I don't have right to do driver's license.
I don't know much details about that, I will try and make some inquiries and see.
So that one is, and sometimes if like some Ghanaians that are still some Ghanaians in Nigeria.
I know that Nigerians, some Nigerians have their cars.
They have some of them, the ones who knows how to speak the language very well.
Very well.
They have the car. But the ones like we that have not learned the.
Like you've not been here for a very long time, so you don't know the language that much.
Like I've not been here for long. So I don't know how to speak the language. So that is some of other problems
that you have
we are facing. So
if you are rating it from, let's say, 1 to 10.
Yes, I will rate, apart from intimidation, I will rate it, because I can't give it 100% or 10%. I will rate it 7%.
7%. Okay, I think that's not bad, because 7% is not bad.
I will rate it 7%.
Okay, then I will thank you. I will thank you so much for this opportunity given. I'm just hoping and praying that if I post this, it will change some minds of some Ghanaians, so that they will start treating Nigerians as our brothers, and they will not continue to behave like the way they do.
But praise of God will touch their
minds. Like their hearts. Yeah. Okay. Thank you. Thank you so much.
Okay. No problem.
Thank you.
Yeah, I appreciate it.